In tonight's battle, Hot Body Jason takes on Mike the Magician in a three-round contest at Mink Nightclub. Each round is a challenge carefully designed to test a player's ability to seduce women in a real-life battlefield. The cameras are hidden, the women are real, and the game is on. Across town at Kai Lounge, our expert panel of pickup commentators with perspectives descending from the four corners of the male psyche. There's Alan, the cold, calculated master of pickup analysis, Peaches, an ex-all-star jock-inspired seduction specialist, Sheldon, the mysteriously coy and unorthodox philosopher, and Chris, a hopelessly romantic man of integrity. Together, they will closely critique each player's performance and crown a single champion. The prize, an epic VIP event where the champion and his closest friends will enjoy full bottle service and the company of our sexy VIP girls. Tonight's champion will celebrate at Century Room. Let's take a closer look at tonight's players. Up first, Hot Body Jason.
Hi, my name is Jason. I'm a kinesiologist. Welcome to my office. Did you know in the lumbar area of the spine, you can stimulate certain nerves, but they'll actually stimulate certain neurotransmitters in women? By day, I'm a kinesiologist. And at night, I'm satisfying women as a stripper.
Hey Mike, I hear you're a magician, but you ain't got tricks like this, baby.
Any guy can go to a website and download the top 10 lines and use them on the girl in the club, but that's not gonna get you anywhere. My game is pretty simple. I'm straightforward, I'm genuine, I'm straight to the point. Magic's great, it's fun, but the truth is, I've never really been rejected. Mikey, may the best man win.
All right, guys. Well, that seemed a little bit offside. Chris, what are your thoughts right now on?
I think we actually literally have Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde here. He's gonna have a lot of confidence, because you have to be a stripper. I think the women are gonna respond to that.
Lies, lies, and more lies. A stripper studying to be a doctor? I don't buy it at all. I've heard that a few times too many.
He has the physical attributes that are necessary to be successful in this field, and hopefully it bodes well for him.
You know what, I'm not really impressed with this guy at all. I think let's have a look at Mike the Magician. He's up next.
And now, Mike the Magician.
Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Mike, and I'm a magician. I've been doing magic for the past 10 years. It's what I eat, live, and breathe. Magic is my life. Magic's really helped build my confidence. You know, I just feel comfortable in front of people. I go out and I just want to have a good time. Women want what they can't have. They want a guy who's different. They want a guy who can go, make them laugh, and be original. I'm gonna do some stuff that you guys are just not gonna believe. Salute!
I chose this shit tonight because Windows was having a stale.
Chris, what are you thinking right now?
I think Mike the Magician might just be one of the most interesting guys we've ever seen on the show. The seductive nature of magic is undeniable. I think he's gonna do great.
I've handpicked this guy myself. He's gonna terrorize this episode. Women cannot resist his magic.
Oh boy.
I think an epic battle is gonna unfold here. You know, brains versus brawn. Hopefully the brains win out for him and he gets to see something disappear, reappear, disappear, reappear at the end of the night.
I predict he goes home alone as per usual. I'm gonna go with Jason, who's actually handled a woman before in his life. Let's let the tape do the talking. Let's check it out.
Coming up after the break.
Hi. Do you remember me?
Yes.
All right, guys, the first game is Reverse Gold Digger. We love this one. What you're gonna try and do is get a girl to buy you a drink for a change. So let's see how Jason, Hot Body Jason, does. Let's check it out.
In round one, each player has 5 minutes to get a woman to buy him a drink. Game on, boys.
Halifax.
Oh, I remember. I was on tour and you saw me perform. Want to get a drink?
Yeah.
Do you notice I was on tour and you saw me perform? Like, he's trying to make stripping sound as if he's like
a rock star or a magician.
Yeah.
Okay, how about this? If you buy this round, I'll buy all your rounds for the rest of the night.
Cheers.
You look beautiful.
Thank you.
So you're gonna give me your number?
Yeah, you want a drink? 416.
bizarre. I'm getting drunk. I have to go. I need to find my friends. Like, that was ridiculous.
I gotta get up early in the morning. This is going too fast.
I'm gonna be around here. Come find me.
Okay, I will.
Well, guys, less is more, I guess.
Yeah.
Chris, what are your thoughts right now?
I'm shocked at what just happened.
Yeah.
Beautiful girl fell into his lap. He did nothing for it. She bought him a drink. It is unbelievable how this unfolded.
If I had a choice in life, I'd rather be a diamond with a flaw than a pearl without.
Yeah.
He's a great-looking guy, and that's why you got the girl. Yeah.
He fulfilled the requirements, right? Whether we saw an exhibition of seduction, you know, that remains to be seen. I don't want to draw any conclusions about him yet because I want to see what he has to do in the rest of the game, but he fulfilled the requirements.
What I'm wondering is he as attractive as a dumb blonde, do you mean, to women? Is he the reverse role? Like, I'm a stripper, like, I don't even know that you, like, are black or anything. Like, I'm just so happy to be here. Dumb blonde Jay, and here we go. Mike the Magician now with the reverse gold digger. Let's see how he does.
Tell me how you really feel.
I want you to imagine that I have an invisible deck of cards, and I want you to take them. And now I want you to take your favorite card out, but you can show it to your friend. Can you see that card? What I have here is a box. Nadia, I want you to hold them. Tell me, what card were you thinking of?
Ace of Hearts.
Ace of Hearts? Listen to this. Nadia, you've been holding that deck the whole time. Look at this. This card box. Take a look. Is that your card?
Yeah, baby.
Oh! And the crowd goes wild.
Oh, my God.
You see that?
Okay, you know what?
Listen,
honestly,
Caroline.
You deserve a drink, and I can't believe it.
You know what? Why don't we line up a couple shots of vodka? Would it be cool if maybe I take you out for dinner sometime?
I normally don't do this. Honestly, I never do this. Like, I would never give up my credit card.
You know what?
But because of the magic trick, I'm gonna have to say you impressed me. You definitely impressed me.
Aww. Well done, Mike. Well done.
I don't know, guys. You know what? If I want my 9-year-old nephew to be entertained at a birthday party, I know who to call. It's Mike the Magician. Yeah. But to bring this guy out to the club to seduce women, I don't know.
What did we just watch? He approached the type of girls that 99% of guys out there are intimidated to approach, and he did it successfully.
But he's got this crutch, you know what I mean? And it just feels like that's all he's got. Sheldon, what are you thinking right now?
I didn't bring him here for his good looks and his magic. It's for his game. He's tight.
Well, if you have a nephew who's going to be entertained, I'm pretty sure you're going to have a mother that's entertained shortly after as well.
I think he did it with a little more panache than Hot Buddy Jason did. So fine, we'll give him the point. 1-0, Mike the Magician. I'm still rooting for my boy, and I think he's going to pull it out in the second game. Let's check it out.
Coming up after the break.
What would you do to get my panties?
Oh? Oh my goodness.
And when we return, Chris reveals the secrets to kissing like a pro. Pay attention, class is in session. The subject, seduction.
Ever wonder what the thin line is between friends and lovers? It's a kiss. When you're flirting, she'll start anticipating a kiss by imagining if you're a good kisser. That sexual tension is fun for her, but once you kiss, it's gone. Tension is what keeps women interested, so you need to learn when and how to kiss. Go for it when the moment's right, but always make sure you're the first to end it. Be playful, touch her face, whisper in her ear, and without getting too eager, start escalating the physical contact. That's the secret to kissing like a pro.
All right, guys, this has been really, really close, and right now we're just gonna open the gates and we'll see what these ponies can do. Let's take a look at Jason in freestyle.
In this round, each player has 5 minutes to impress us with his unique seductive abilities. There's no rules this time, boys. It's freestyle.
How you guys doing?
Good.
You guys are looking good. Yeah. It's getting better and better.
Some enthusiasm might help here.
What, are you gonna be dancing at all?
That's good, but you know what? It'd be better if I was in between you.
It sounds like he's reading a teleprompter or something. I think it'll be better if I was in between you.
Are you wearing underwear?
I am.
Not much of any, eh?
What would you do to get my panties?
Huh?
Oh my goodness.
What?
Does this guy have to work for anything?
You know what? He probably walks into a job interview and they're just like, okay, we'll give you a corner office, we'll give you 250 grand a year.
I'll pretty much do anything to get your panties.
Do it. Bottom of my back, all the way up, and I'll go in the corner and get my panties.
Well, that's something to consider.
You want a spare panty?
No, maybe. Oh my god. You want me to lick your back?
All the way up.
What?
Yeah, actually, my name is Jay. What's your number?
416.
Thank you again, guys.
They usually say don't air your dirty laundry, but in public, but in this case I'd make an exception, I think. Chris?
I think the fact that he's a stripper has made him so conditioned around women that everything comes off nonchalantly, and that's part of his game.
Ignorance is bliss. He's got that stupid smile on his face, but he has no clue how he got three women and her underwear.
How can you argue with that? I'm so stupid, but here I am with three women and a pair of underwear. Ooh.
I think his game falls in line with that whole notion of never let them see you coming.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? He's always under the radar, like a stealth bomber, and you know, he always hits his target.
You did a great job with this. Let's take a look at Mike, the magician, and let's see what he can do with it.
In the club,
he's the leader of men now because of his hijinks. Look at this.
The leader of three nerds. And let me tell you the difference between him and Jason. Nerd one, nerd two, nerd three, one girl. Jason, three chicks, all staring at him going, when will you lick my back?
Check it out. This is my piece of gum. Watch the gum. Just blow on it. When you blow it hard enough, you can do something crazy. Look. Go.
Really?
Hey, listen, I gotta get your number.
Well done.
Yeah.
I refuse to clap for these cheap parlor tricks, these gimmicks. Chris?
Oh, what, you're gonna clap for some stinky underwear being pulled over?
Yes. Yes, sir, I am.
Oh, wait. This guy had fireworks going off here in this round. He was a spectacle, and she loved it.
He's a performer, and this club is his stage. He's just having a great time.
He actually created the situation. Yeah. But you know, the leader of men, the tribal leader, also leads the woman. Yeah. It's just that simple. And I think this is a great showing for a guy who I would think otherwise wouldn't have any game whatsoever. Like, look at him. Like, really, look at him.
I don't know, in his next game of Dungeons & Dragons, I'm sure that his little magic tricks are going to be make him the king of the forum post, but I don't know. How are we scoring this? Are we giving him a point here?
I'm saying 1-1.
Chris?
I think it's fair to say 1-1.
Peaches?
It's a tie.
I'm surprised that you guys give any credit to Jason, and I like that. I like that. Let's call 1-1. That means it's 2-1, going into the third. I know my boy Jason's going to pull it out. Let's check out the third game.
Coming up after the break.
I'm gonna bite half of it from your mouth, but I promise I'm not gonna touch your lips.
And later, the exciting conclusion to tonight's battle.
All right, guys, Jason Kiss close, 2-1. I still think it's wide open. Let's check it out.
In round three, we've upped the stakes. Each player must try and obtain a kiss. Good luck, boys.
I heard you have a crush on me.
Okay.
I'm going to go buy a drink, because I promise no one.
Divide and conquer. He's taken her away from the group. He's created an intimate atmosphere for her. They're talking, he's upping the sexual ante. Maybe I don't know anything about game. Please, Chris, enlighten me.
He's doing okay. Uh-oh. But it's with somebody he already built rapport with earlier. And somebody that was actually the sexual aggressor in the situation.
Okay, come here.
Okay.
How's it going?
Are you having a good time?
If we would all be this lucky.
Yeah. I have to use the washroom.
So do I.
I gotta go. Are you going? Okay.
I don't know. I don't even know where the washroom is.
I'll show you.
And that was the moment right there that let you know it was a facade. Like, he didn't know where he was going. Well, Sheldon,
I think I have a new philosophy for this guy, and it's that success will find those who are too clueless to look for it. You know what I mean? Like, he's just gonna find it no matter what. He doesn't know what he's doing out there.
Well, you know what? He's so fortunate that he keeps bumping into women that are actually the aggressors in the situation. They're the ones escalating everything, and then he's just reaping the reward.
He was the Scooby-Doo of pickups.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? He stumbled, he bumbled, he fumbled, but yet he still ended up solving the mystery. So, kudos to him and kudos to the result. However, it's the same girl, and he leaves the window wide open for Mike the Magician.
Jason, to me, is looking like Merlin, because he's pulling off some serious magic, yeah. And he's on his way to the bathroom. Unless Mike does something amazing here, I gotta say that Jason's gonna win this one.
That is the hottest tattoo I've ever seen.
Really?
I'm not gonna lie. But one thing, I just don't know if I'm feeling the hair right now.
Why?
I think you can get so much more volume in it. And the crazy thing is, my buddy, he's the craziest hairstylist. I'm gonna hook you up with him. I'm gonna introduce you to him. What's your name?
Christina.
My name's Mike. It's a pleasure to meet you, Christina.
Thank you, Mike.
Do you have a boyfriend?
Not anymore, no.
Not anymore? No. What does that mean, over. Not anymore?
That means it's over with. No more boyfriend.
Done with?
Done with.
Oh my gosh, you have dimples. Listen.
He bumped her for an opening. He gave her a little neg. He revalidated her by saying he saw potential. Now he's touching her cheeks, little Kino escalation. You know where this is gonna end. He's just gonna keep going until he closes.
And you need to dust a little dirt off your shoulder there, bro.
Thank you.
I'm gonna show you something. You might believe it, you might not. Watch this. Piece of gum, okay? Look. I gotta ask you something. I want you to bite half of it, just bite half. I'm gonna bite half of it from your mouth. But I promise I'm not gonna touch your lips. Can I do it? Watch this.
Wow. Incredible.
Listen, I'm gonna get your number right now.
416. Nice meeting you.
Nice to meet you.
Awesome. That was amazing.
All right, I think I might retract my earlier statements, but yeah. Sheldon, I mean, I'm concerned about turning over to look at you because I know I can feel the gloating happening. Talk to me right now.
Honestly, I'm like a proud, proud coach. I brought this guy. He is delivered in textbook fashion. There's nothing more he could have done to do better.
Yeah.
He's an inspiration. This guy is an inspiration to men everywhere right now.
Men or nerds?
Boys, men, nerds, whatever you want to call it. He came in three solid rounds. He intrigued the women. He captured their imagination. He was a spectacle, and he won over the crowd. Unbelievable. And, you know, it takes a man with true game to create romance around a little stick of gum.
Yeah. Beautiful. Peaches.
I'm really proud of Mike right now. He lacked all the physical traits in comparison to Jason.
Yeah.
Let's just be, you know, blunt. Straight up about it. And the fact that he went three rounds, a bunch of different women, took risks, was successful in those risks, it's fantastic. You know, he's the winner in my mind.
I'm gonna actually agree with you guys. And what we've decided, I think, on this show is that looks and game are mutually exclusive. And while Jason's a good-looking guy, our friend Mike has game. And he has this uncanny ability for making women feel comfortable around him. And for that, I say we raise a glass to Mike the Magician. Congratulations, you're our champion tonight. Enjoy the VIP experience.
Yeah! Tonight's champion is Mike the Magician.
That's gonna leave a mark.